plastic raw material basics. Here we will be looking after how to select the raw material, what are the types of raw material, all these things we will be covering in detail. So this is the family of polymers. So plastic, many of us will be knowing this still for the academic purpose, for everybody's knowledge I am explaining this. So plastic material is basically divided into two types. One is thermoset and second is thermoplastics. So our subject is thermoplastics. What is thermoplastics and thermoset? What is the behavior? I'll go to the next slide. It will be described. And in thermoplastic, there are majorly two types of plastics. One is engineering plastic. Second is commodity plastic. Commodity plastic means those plastic which you are using for regular use, like PE, PP, and all, which goes into cup, mugs, caps and closures, hair combs and all, whatever regular uses, whatever use is known as commodity plastic. Those goes in high volumes. And they will have a lower property wise. And engineering plastic are the plastic which are used for, specifically for engineering purpose. Okay, which will be even suppose electrical products, our switch products, maybe. Then submarine pumps and aerospace application, electrical, electronics application. All these things come under engineering plastic. Okay, these have a better property. It comes at a higher cost. Whatever plastic we take, irrespective of commodity or engineering plastic, it has to be divided into two segments. One is amorphous plastic and one is crystalline plastic. So commodity also, amorphous plastic means acrylic, PMMA. I'll go in deep, just wait. And polystyrene, PVC, all these things come amorphous plastics. And crystalline plastic is polypropylene, polyethylene. And in engineering, PC, ABS, PPO all comes under amorphous, and second crystalline PBT and nylons. So this understanding of this plastic is very, very important for selection. So how to select it, how to narrow down it, I'll be going in deep. Now just for the purpose, understand there is amorphous and there is crystalline. Whenever we are selecting any raw material for any application, first we have to narrow down it to whether I have to go for amorphous, whether I have to go for crystalline. Then you can dig into multiple raw material grades. Okay. So what is a thermoplastic? Thermoplastic material is like ice water principle. Whenever it is cooled, it becomes solid. And whenever we heat it, it becomes liquid. And this plastic, whenever our normal nylon or polycarbonate, whenever we heat it, it becomes like a liquid or a semi-liquid form, paste form. And whenever we cool it, it cools and become a part, solid part. And it is a reversible process. Any number of time, you can heat it, cool it, it changes shape from solid and liquid. And it principally is like ice and water. Any number of time, it can be interchanged. This is the basic of a thermoplastics. Our nylon, polycarbonate, PP, everything, whatever we use comes under thermoplastics. So this is thermoset. Thermoset means the name itself says thermoset. This gets set, will get set under temperature and pressure. It is like a cake baking process. Once we take a cake dough and we keep it in an oven, make a cake and keep it in oven. Once it becomes the cake, we cannot change back to the dough. And like water and ice principle. This is once it is set, there is a chemical changes happening in a thermoplastic. Physical form changes here in thermoset. Chemical reaction happen and chemical changes happen, and there is a cross linking happening. So once it is done, we cannot reverse the process. So thermoset process are like it cannot be recycled, because when it is set, it cannot be reversed back to its original form by heating and all. Okay, the earlier day switches like melamine switches, and now plate also comes, melamine plates. All these are made of thermosets. So this is a famous plastic pyramid. This pyramid, everybody in plastic should know. This pyramid, if you see, the bottom side of the pyramid, it's a commodity segment. Commodity means the polymers which are lower in cost, which have lower properties and goes in bulk. And in this also, there are two, it can be divided into amorphous and crystalline. So how you can understand amorphous and crystalline? So whenever you are thinking about amorphous or crystalline, just bring into your mind two plastics, polycarbonate and nylon. I think everybody will be knowing polycarbonate and nylon. Polycarbonate is a transparent, hard plastic. Nylon is a plastic, you know, it's little bit soft, but it is having a lot of engineering properties and it warps a lot. It bends. Whenever you mold, it bends a lot. So think your product, whether it is close to polycarbonate or close to nylon. Based on that, just narrow down the selection. So amorphous plastic basic properties are clarity, colorability and impact strength. We might have seen, if you just compare our polycarbonate part and a nylon part, polycarbonate part always, you know, shining, lot of colors, multiple colors we can give. Okay, it is having very good clear, like a transparent. Most of the case, amorphous plastic are transparent. PVC is transparent, polystyrene is transparent. So all this comes in amorphous plastics. And moreover, amorphous plastic have a lot of other properties that will be going to the next slide. And crystalline plastic is having better chemical resistance. So whenever you see, you know, kerosene can or petrol jar, or wherever you see there is a chemical reaction coming, okay, chemical agent is going to contact, then you have to use crystalline plastics. So crystalline plastic has a better chemical property and have a very good flow. You might have seen, you know, nylon parts, the flash comes very easily. But whereas polycarbonate plus doesn't flash. This is because of its flowability. And crystalline plastic have very good electrical properties also. So that's why PBT is a crystalline plastic we use for lot of electrical parts. Yes, you may be correlating. We may be using polycarbonate in a lot of outer area and all. But whenever we go to the internal, wherever high current comes, fuse or something, we used to go for PBT. This is the reason it's having very good electrical properties. So amorphous plastic, polystyrene, which we see in our razor blades, no, cover of a razor blade, transparent part. That is a polystyrene. It is a transparent. Then polyvinyl chloride, PVC. Is also amorphous plastic. And in the same area, if you see right side, crystalline, polyethylene, PE and PP, like cups, buckets, all bulk polymers. They are very cheaper material, but goes in bulk and property-wise, they are lower. And we go to the second level, you can see polycarbonate, ABS, polycarbonate, ABS blend, then PPO, it's a noryl. It's the lowest water absorption polymer. Many of us may not be used, but it is used in water management application. Our pumps and all, PPO is used. Pumps, no, water pumps and submersible pumps. And the right side, you can see PBT. PBT and polyamide is a classic example for crystalline engineering plastics. And if you go up still further, the cost of the metal goes drastically up. They are known as high performance polymers, PI, polyamide. Then PPSU, polysulfones, PEI, like Ultim used to tell, which Amar may be knowing in your MCBs and all, wherever hooks and all, higher temperature, wherever 200 degree operation temperature is square. Polycarbonate can go up to 130 degree. PP can go up to only 50 to 60 degree of operation temperature, company's temperature. So PEI can go up to 200 degree. Then crystalline peak, aerospace application and peak can go up to 180, 200 degree of. The melt temperature, melting itself goes up to 400 degree. So this is high temperature application, LCP, okay, high temperature nylons. In mobile phones and all, inside the mobile phone, high temperature nylons and we used. So cost of the material also goes up. This PEI, known as Ultim, costs starting itself from $25 a kg. Whereas polycarbonate, you know, $5-$6 a kg. This go up to $25 to $35 starting itself. A kg. This is the cost of high performance. They goes in very low volumes, but very, very, you know, it is like a replacement for metal. Some case, higher temperature application, all these things, higher performance polymers comes into picture. So now very, very, this slide, no, is very, very important for everybody. Whenever we are selecting any raw material for any application, first we should narrow down whether amorphous or semi-crystalline plastics. Amorphous, again, I'm repeating, amorphous plastic and semi-crystalline, what is the basic difference? The basic difference is the arrangement of the molecular structures. Every polymer is made up of some monomers. A small monomer will be, it is connected and it make a big bunch of polymer. Small things will be connected, interconnected, and we will be making a bunch of things. That is known as polymer. So amorphous, you see, amorphous is like a random arrangement. If you see through a microscope, it is randomly arranged, like cotton. Semicrystalline has a specific structure. You can see it is a bundle shape. Always it has a proper bundle shape. And so randomly arrangement and amorphous have a good clarity, transparency, colorability, any number of colors. If you are, red, green, multiple array of arrangement of colors can be given. And it has a good impact strength. Like if you see a bulletproof, bulletproof polycarbonate is used. Okay, multi-layer polycarbonate. Because it has a good impact strength. Something hits on it, it takes the impact load. But it doesn't have a repeatedly, you cannot impact it repeatedly. Since you can see, polycarbonate sutures sometimes breaks. Because it has a good impact strength. But again, repeatedly it use, it may give a failure. That's why in chair and all, we use nylons. Chair, castor wheel, chair bottom side. Nobody use polycarbonate. Because polycarbonate cannot be loaded again and again and again. It fractures. But it has a good impact strength. Once something gets impact, it doesn't pierce off. And more very, very important property is dimension stability and a very good low warpage. So nobody use PP or nylon for a switch part or a critical dimension part, because you will not get a dimension. After some time, it bends away. It bends. Internal part, not like an internal part. So dimension stability for amorphous is very, very, very good dimension. If you have a tight tolerance like 0.105 plus or minus 0.5, you cannot use semi-crystalline. You have to use amorphous. This is chemically, successful. Chemical, wherever chemical, you are chemical carrying something and you are doing some amount of, large amount of chemical reaction like painting or secondary operation. In polycarbonate, if you use grease, after some time it cracks. So this is chemically this is not so good. So you should not keep lot of chemical grease, putting grease cleaning. We might have seen sutures cracks in a hospital atmosphere quite often, because people clean with that chemical solvents in a hospital, then it cracks. So chemically these are very poor. This takes moderate heat. Okay, these are moderate heat. Then transparent, very low shrinkage. So whenever we are doing a mold design for amorphous, we are very safe. Whatever we give, we'll get the result. But nylon or POM is like Delrin. We used to tell Delrin. People tell, we don't know what will happen. Nylon, you put some dimension, you may not get the same dimension, because it is having a wide range of shrinkage. Okay, it shrinks. 2%, 3% it shrinks. And amorphous has a wide softening temperature. And I will tell you why crystalline shrinks a lot. Okay, this is very important. So whenever any plastic gets heated, whenever you are putting in a machine, we are heating it and we are injecting the mold and making it to cool. So amorphous plastic, when it is a cool condition, we look through the microscope, it is having the same random condition. The molecule will be randomly arranged. When we heat it, then also it remains the same condition, because already it is like a sponge, like a cotton. It is randomly arranged. It cannot further expand or change this shape. So it is in cool condition, heat condition, its molecular structure remains the same. But semi-crystalline, it is not. Semi-crystalline at a real condition, it's like a bundle. You can see a lot of bundles, like bundle shape. Whenever we heat it, it goes to amorphous kind of shape. All these things opens up, all these bundles opens up and go to the like a cotton shape, like opens up in a random shape. And whenever we cool it, it has to come back to the same shape. So it changes its phase when we are heating and cooling. Amorphous remains in the same condition. The semicrystalline, it changed to this in heating and come back to this. So there's a phase changing happening. That's why it having more shrinkage. So whenever we heat, it expands and all the molecules, expands and become like a random arrangement. Whenever we cool, it comes back and it has to become again bundle. So the phase changes is giving all these problems. Your shrinkage problem, your warpage, it bends. Sometimes it warps a lot. Okay, you may be, warps means it bends a lot. So all these problems is due to this property of the plastic. So we should understand that whenever we are selecting semi-crystalline, it is going to give a bigger shrinkage and warpage. So whenever we make a tool, we should keep in the mold some compensation allowance or some tolerance so that that can be met. The same mold cannot be used for polycarbonate and nylon, because polycarbonate will give a straight part, nylon will give a different. So this is what the difference, major difference. Due to this molecular property, it is totally different. So we should understand that. So in semi-crystalline, our aim is to have a robust part. We should know, do a molding process, and mold should be made such a way that we should be able to, after injection, we will be able to make it a bundle. It's a real position, real shape. Then we'll get a better part. Whereas it has a lot of good property, like good fatigue endurance. Because if you are giving again repeatedly load, again, okay, there is a flexible element in a part. Again, we are giving a load. Then semi-crystalline gives a good result. We cannot go with amorphous. So every plastic has its own benefit and demerits. So based on our application, we should understand what is the temperature you should take, what is the mechanical property you should have, whether it should have a clarity, colorability, whether this part is going to withstand any chemical property, whether the chemical petrol is coming into contact with this. If petrol comes in contact, we have to use semi-crystalline like PP, POM, P in US, in our chemical tanks wherever oil is stored, Indian oil or whatever petroleum, inside the tank they will P coating, because those semi-crystalline metal only can withstand that chemical reaction. If you use polycarbonate, it cracks like anything. So that is why semi-crystalline has its own property. As I told, chair, the wheel of the chair or that base of the chair, we cannot use polycarbonate, hard plastic, we cannot use it, because continuously, cyclic load, it fractures. But semi-crystalline, can be used for cyclic load. That's why nylon is used in that application. And it's having very good wear resistance. So wherever wear is there, you have seen POM, Delrin is used. Even in sutures also, there is an internal part wherever sliding happens. There also, wherever wear and tear application is there, you have to go for semi-crystalline. From there, you have to narrow down it. And that is softening temperature, that's not matter a lot. Because semi-crystalline, every material, whenever we heat it, everything goes to that. Because that molecular shape is in a bundle. Suddenly, the bundle starts breaking. That's why it's told it has a very specific melting temperature. Whenever we see any data sheet of nylon, we can see 260, 265, 270 like that. 10, 15 degree only melting temperature. But polycarbonate, if you see, it will be like 250, 260, 270, 283. A wide range will be there. So amorphous plastic can be processed in a very wide range, but semi-crystalline has a very narrow window. That's why semi-crystalline, you may be seeing, material comes out of the nozzle, nylons or PBT blocks quite easily. Nozzle blocking happens, all these things in semi-crystalline, issue due to melting temperature very narrow. So now, hope everybody understood about amorphous and semi-crystalline. Now it's a question time. Let me check. So which is the material used for fuel tank? If fuel tank, abhi apna gaadi ka two-wheeler fuel tank is there, or automotive fuel internal, there is a liner, plastic is being used. Which plastic metal you'll use, whether amorphous or semi-crystalline, and why it is so? Yes, you can answer.
We'll use semi-crystalline, okay, because it will not react with the petrol.
It has a good chemical property.
Good chemical property. It will not react. It will not show reaction with the petrol.
Okay, great.
Yes.
Okay, good. So next question, why polycarbonate? Polycarbonate used in sutures. Everybody house there is sutures. Okay, polycarbonate is used widely, not PP or nylons. Who can answer this? Prashantji, you can just throw a light on this. Why polycarbonate is used? Switch plates.
Because of its impact, it has a good impact strength.
Yes.
Because every time when we use it, we will have impact on it.
It has a very good impact strength. Second, it has a very good glossy appearance. Amorphous has a very good glossy finish. you can go, give a good color, it shines. So sutures is an appearance part. So it goes. Moreover, it has a electrical, whenever we put a fire retardant, it has a good electrical properties also. And third question is, why nylon and PBT warps? Warping means it bends. After molding, if you take out, it bends. So who will be answer? Amar, you can just throw a light on this.
Yeah, nylon is basically, this is a crystalline material.
Yes.
And it bends because the structure, the molecular structure also, it's
yes,
it's not like of the amorphous.
Yes, absolutely.
So the tendency of warping is more.
Yes.
In case of nylon and PBT. Yes. It's a softer material.
Yes. So why it warps means whenever we heat it, it goes from its original shape, molecular shape, it goes to the amorphous kind of shape. And when cool, it has to come back. So there is a phase change, you know, it is expanding and contracting. But amorphous, whenever we heat, cool, it has the same shape, molecular structure. So no phase change is happening. So it doesn't warp amorphous. But crystalline, since it is changing the shape when heating and cooling, obviously it will bend, you know. It doesn't have a control. So it bends, warps. Okay. Next question is, what family of metal we suggest for a highly... I have a very, very critical dimension part, whether I will go for amorphous or crystalline. Devendraji, you can give a...
We should be going in for basically amorphous material. And if the dimensional stability required is very high, then it makes sense to go for amorphous engineering polymers.
Absolutely.
As... They have a very good dimensional stability, and the best part about these material is that repeatability is also very good if processing parameters are controlled properly.
Yes, absolutely. This is very easy to process and dimensionally very, very stable, because amorphous plastic remains the same shape when it's, you know, molecular structure when it's heated and cooling. So we will get a very easily done, because its shrinkage is very less. It will not expand and contract a lot. So whenever you see the data sheet of any amorphous polycarbonate 0.5 PPO Nyryl, whatever Devendraji is using for our solar application, is amorphous. Very, very, you know, 0.3, 0.4 is there. So somebody use, you know, what is the shrinkage of this metal, and no need of worry. First of all, think whether it's amorphous or crystalline. Narrow down based on the property. Then amorphous, you can say approximate 0.5, 0.6. ABS is 0.6. Normally it goes. Whenever we are asking about semi-crystalline, nylon, like, and PP, then it goes to 1 to 2. It cannot be predicted based on the molding condition, mold condition, gate condition, all these in various. But generally 1 to 2%, and some POM is POM, like we used to tell, Deldrin is highly crystalline. Very, very difficult to control the dimension. People use, keep mold it and keep it. Some people keep 3-4 days before using it. Like gas meter and all, they use POM. So they keep 4 days. After that only it comes to the real dimension. Okay. Because it is highly crystalline. It takes time to come to its bundle shape. Since highly crystalline. So dimensionally, very, very difficult. Okay. To meet. So this is about basic raw material selection. Why we are using polypropylene for a bucket application, suppose? Why? Because it's the cheapest raw material available, bulk polymer available. Moreover, no, when we add some UV retardant, it can be kept outside in the sunlight also. We have seen, no, some buckets and all, we keep outside for a long time, 3-4 months. We take it, a puppet, it will break. You might have seen. But our electrical switches or something, we keep it outside, it doesn't crack. Our solar junction box connector, it doesn't crack because it has a good ultraviolet UV okay. property. There are some additives added.
And very good weatherability.
Weatherability, yes. It is known as FN weatherability.
And the best part is that very low water absorption.
Yes, absolutely.
For Noryl.
Yes. So Noryl is a amorphous plastic. It is the lowest. It absorbs very least moisture. So we'll be going to that also later on.